In today's Excel video, I'm going to show you how you can create a sales funnel chart in Excel that looks like this one. Some time ago, there was a comment from one of the viewers of this channel who said they would like to see my take on the sales funnel chart. So here it is. Now, this is some sample data set that we have. It's sorted. So first we have prospect, then we have contact, initial visit, opportunity, and client. Now in Excel 2016, you already have an inbuilt sales funnel chart. All we have to do is click somewhere in our data set. We're going to go to insert and click on this little icon here to see more charts. We can actually already see it in recommended charts, but we can also see it if you click on all charts, and at the bottom we see the funnel chart. Right, so in 2016, that's how it looks. That's how it also looks in Power BI. And in the older versions where this wasn't available, the general solution or the most common solution was to create a bar chart, right? And this part, so the part on the bottom that's white, that was set to invisible. But in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can turn this Excel 2016 funnel chart to something that looks like this. But you can apply the same concept to the bar chart version as well. So that's our sample data set. First thing I'm going to do, make sure the data is sorted. In this case, it is. I'm going to go to insert. I'm just going to click on recommended charts because it's going to come up. I'm going to click on this and click on OK. Now the funnel chart is one of these newer chart types that was added here. And the newer ones, they don't have the flexibility that we have in the older ones. And we're going to come across one of the restrictions in here as well. We're going to see that in a bit. Now this funnel chart is pretty much ready, right? So we don't really need to do anything except maybe change the colors and make this more readable. If I wanted to have different colors for each of these, I just have to double click on one of these series and then just change the color. So I'm going to go to the home tab and let's say change that color to a yellow. And then I can click again and the second one, just so that you see that one highlighted and the other one's not, and then you can change the color of the other one as well. But now what we're going to do is to not just change the color, but also make it look like a funnel. So I'm going to go to the Insert tab. From there, I'm going to insert a SmartArt. So click on SmartArt. Let's go down to Pyramid, and I'm going to click on this one and click on OK. Now I have the ability to add text here and so on, but all of this is static, right? It's not dynamic. So what I'm going to do is first to add in the number of shapes I have in my chart. Okay, so that's my number of categories. In this case, there are 5. So I'm going to click on add shape. I need to click it again. So I have 2 more shapes added here. And now here comes the deal. I'm actually going to convert this to a normal shape. I don't want it as a smart art. So I'm going to right mouse click on this shape and say convert to shapes. Now they're just normal shapes. So what I'm going to do is to change the color of each one to the color that I want to ultimately have in my chart. So for this one, let's go with yellow, the other one, orange, and for the last one, a green. Okay, so these are the colors that I ultimately want to have here. So now this is what I have to do. I'm going to click. So basically select the first one, press Control C. Now, here's the difference between the new charts and the core, you know, the older Excel charts, is that I could click on a series and do Control V. But look what happens if I do this here. I just put a shape on top of this, right? The shape is not even inside the chart. So what I need to do is not click and do Control V, but instead go to the fill options here, select a picture. Now I'm going to select clipboard. Okay, so because it was copied to my clipboard, and now I'm going to click away and I have my chart with this blue border, right? So let's take away the border from all of this. I'm just going to click on this once, go to format under shape outline, click on no outline. I have now the look for the first one. I just have to repeat that for the other one. So Control C, click, click, go to fill options, click on picture, click on clipboard. And then the same thing for the other ones. Okay, so that gives me a funnel chart that really looks like a funnel. I can decrease the gap width here. I'm actually gonna take it to 0. That's not gonna cover the entire gap, and I don't want that either because I do have a white line in here as well. So I do have a white border in there. Let's just make sure it's dynamic. So that's my 76 is for opportunity. Let's change that to 90. That updates. Let's change this to 40 and that updates as well. Okay, so this is how you can tweak the funnel chart to make it look like a funnel. I hope you liked this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. If you enjoy these type of videos, you want to become more advanced in Excel, you haven't subscribed to this channel, consider subscribing.